got a verse for you all. Teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart of wisdom. There is a time to die and there is a time to be born. My leaders, this message is going to be a little different today because it's to many would be considered morbid, but it's not. It's not. A speaker hit me the other day with this verse. Teach me to number our days. And what hit me was, why would we want to do that? What does that even mean? It means that we need to start remembering our mortality. The fact that we're not going to be here forever. And what does that do? When you know, let's say you may have like a year or two, maybe a decade. If you knew, if the medical report came in and you knew this is how much time you had, you would maneuver in such a different way. There would be no excuses. And I just think because last night around 5:04 in the morning, I remember looking at a post that I couldn't believe. And it was a friend of mine who in the past, November 25th, who I found out passed away. And this was a phenomenal, phenomenal individual. We did beautiful photography together, and she was one of the first people in my life when I was really doing my photography and building it that truly believed in me. She believed in my work. She was ready to spend as much money as she needed just so I can do her photos. She wouldn't hire nobody. You know what I mean? She was like, yo, give me that price, whatever the price is. I'ma spend it. I love your work. And she valued what I did. And she wore her heart on her sleeves. You know, pro-black. Just a beautiful spirit who always was looking out for other people's well-being. All the time. To always looking for people's well-being. Like, how are you doing? You know, what's going on in your life? And, you know, you always felt welcome to talk about life. Because she was so ready to listen. And when I heard the news, it made me think to myself, like, wow, you know, I'm here today, right? I'm here today until I'm no longer here. Lord, teach me to number my days and realize that all of us at some point in time are not going to be here. This is a great concept to grasp because it allows us to know that there's a time to be born and there's a time to die. And while we're here on this faith platform, we are here as leaders called to make an impact. God wants us here to make an impact. You and I are the leaders who are going to lead people to Jesus Christ. Help people, you know, find the Lord and Savior and be anchored. Find their salvation. Find themselves, their identities. You know, help people get out of suicide and depression. We're here to help make such an impact. Help the widows. Help the young adults, the kids without fathers or mothers. You know, we are here to make an impact for such a time. And it just ignited my fire thinking about it because, you know, this was an individual who helped me continue to see my vision when I was doing photography and allowed me to know I always wanted to capture timeless moments. But I wanted to also help them. I wanted to be there for people. I wanted to speak to people during the photography. I wanted to know what they were going through in their own life and just be able to pray and impart wisdom. And this individual just reminded me how, regardless of what you do as a leader watching this platform, you know, most of y'all are believers as well too, God is going to use you. And I was telling a friend of mine, McLeod, about this, about purpose and how, you know, God is not going to use us the same way. And in fact, he says to his disciples, I'm going to make you fishers of men. And when you think about fishers, think about how when somebody is in a boat and they have the fishing rod, and if you've ever been fishing, you realize to capture a specific type of fish, you need to be able to put a specific type of bait on the fishing rod. And in this bait, you're going to catch different varieties, different selectives. This is you and I. You and I have different gifts, like the word speaks about, who is going to connect you to different people. You know, Because different people are going to be drawn to you. They're going to be drawn to your gifts, your talents, your singing, your service, the way you run business so successfully, right? The way you may be pursuing your academics and you're just a scholar and you're called to be like some great teacher. You know, whatever it is, if you do it at a high level, this is a level of bait that attracts people towards you. You know, it attracts. Not everybody's just going to be speaking and you're speaking about God and have people drawn towards them. Many times it's going to be in your actions and what you're gifted in. And because of me focusing on photography and continuing to build this platform, I would have never met a Bre Shelton. I would have never met that phenomenal soul. I would have never had the opportunity to connect with such an amazing spirit. And it made me realize, like, Lord, I want to connect with more of your leaders. I want to connect with more of your sheep. And give me the energy to do it while I'm here today. Let me not take this breath for granted. Let me know that my days are numbered. And I just want to remind you, my leader, your days are numbered. And this is not a bad thing. This is life. You didn't ask to leave. You didn't ask to be born. And you definitely have no say in when you leave, right? And so, my leader, God wants to use you. You are very important. If you're watching this today, one thing I know about you, God wants to use you. You're not watching this platform for no reason. You haven't been a part of like the 30, 40 people that show up every video for no reason. You have been called a leader and you're attracted to these messages because this is bait. This is nothing but a fishing hook. I don't got to try to be nothing I'm not. I just got to speak directly to you because you got a duty. You got purpose. You got mission. God wants to use that. Your days are numbered, my leader, and this is a good thing because God only needs so many days out of you in order for your life to be effective. It's not about the longevity, but it's what you do with what you've been granted. There's a leadership book that I'm reading, and I believe it was by the great Dr. Miles Monroe. He said, when a leader makes an impact in this world, the physicality and the physical nature of this person may leave. But you know what stays the same? The impact. Impact never leaves. It just doesn't. Impact stays here. Think of greats like your favorite athletes like Kobe or some of your favorite musicians. Think about the impact of Jesus Christ. Even though his physical nature left, his impact was still here on this earth. And this is what eternity is about. The flesh leaves, but the spirit is eternal. And so this phenomenal friend of mine has not left anything. I'll never forget this person. Just like I'll never forget my friend Nelson. I'll never forget these individuals. I'll never forget. Why? Because their impact, who they were, has rubbed off on me. And I pray that you can be the same for somebody else. I would pray that the videos that I'm called to make while I'm here truly, and the energy that I'm called to leave makes an impact on somebody's life. So my leader, I just thank you for being who you are. I want you to know something. You're very important. You are a representation of what God wanted here on this earth. That's why you're here. Okay, my leader. This just came to me, y'all. I'm reminiscing. You know, fun fact, Bre Shelton was the first person, my first client, that bought my photography at a new price range. Back in 3 years ago, the time we shot, I had been doing videography, photography, but I had been undercharging. And God has showed me that, you know, you can't actually charge your work. There's gonna be people who value your work, who like your work. And so I remember, you know, I upped my production and I was charging $520 now. And I said, God, nobody's going to pay for my photography at $520. Nobody. But I have faith. I have faith, y'all. I have faith. I have faith. And Lord behold, because of this level of faith, know who God brought to me? Bre Shelton. I just remembered that just now. Bre Shelton was the first person to buy my $520 photography package, and it changed my life. You know, this is not about money, but this is about how there's certain things, there's certain acts, there's certain people who can believe in you that changes your life. And it changed how I charged my photography. And when I was doing photography and I wasn't life coaching, this allowed photography to sustain me and not have to work for all those years that I didn't have to work, you know. And I just got to share this with y'all. Bre Shelton was the first person to buy my photography at $520 at the time, 3 years ago. And so I just had to share that because I just thought that's the power of believing. You know, we got to invest in people we believe in. And she invested in the community. She invested in the Black community. She invested in what she believed in. And so my dedication moving forward this year, invest in things I believe in, invest in people I believe in, invest in the tasks that I believe in. That's what I just got inspired to tell you all, y'all. Bre Shelton, I thank you for believing in me. Now I got to pay it forward and believe in somebody else. Now we finished. We out. Bre Shelton, I know you're watching this in heaven. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for coming into my life. Thank you for, as a woman, encouraging me as a male, especially as an African-American male who was just looking to pursue a business, anything out of pre-pharmacy. You gave me encouragement. You uplifted my spirit. You were a leader in my life as well, too. Even being somebody that was younger than me. And I just thank you for being that leader. Thank you for encouraging me. Thank you for believing in my ability to take your images out of the thousands of photographers who you could have chose. I thank you for believing in me. And because you believed in me, I started to believe in myself more. And because of this, I'm not going to take this any of the knowledge you've given me or the experience that we learned together for granted. I know now that you just spoke to me. God used you to speak to me. And I know what I need to continue to do even more of this year. Thank you. You are a blessing to us all. You are a blessing to my life. You are a blessing to your friends. You have made an impact, and it's forever, forever going to be in our heart. So, Bre Shelton, from the bottom of my heart, I love you. I'm pretty sure everybody else could say the same. Rest in paradise until we meet again. Yeah.
Mother's home. You would show me I had something some people call a soul. And you drive top the sky. Oh, you when I was 3 years old. No one knows me like the piano in my mother's home. And you know I
touching my hair. When it's the feelings I wear, don't touch my soul. When it's the rhythm I know, don't touch my crown. They see the vision I've found. Don't touch what's there. When it's the feelings I wear, they don't understand what it means to me. But we chose to go.
In my mother's home.